Bobby May! He just went right through it. Like I said countless times, I'm glad I'm not down there. And then he just swing around, around, around like the merry-go-round broke down. And what else? Let me reiterate something else. I know at one point I'm probably supposed to say I haven't seen the EVA show yet. Well, that's up now. Oh, and surprise, surprise, the man doing the commentary for it as this thing turns into an outside brawl was none other than BYU's founding father, Hawkins 07. And I'll tell you what, when I heard Hawkins 07 doing the commentary for that, I thought to myself one thing. I always wondered what that guy sounded like. But anyway, yeah, because during the whole time I worked for him, that's what I wondered, as we just saw Steve Farrell with a testicular claw on Psycho Ed. And yeah. But yeah, I mean, it was his first time doing commentary, Hawkins. So just cut him a little slack, guys. I mean, he even admitted he wasn't all that good, but I didn't think he was that bad. And I enjoyed his commentary. I mean, maybe he needs a little bit more enthusiasm like me, but I think he did okay. Hey, right now, Farrell. Oh, look at him just hammer away on Psycho Edge. And man, I'm still angry. Still angry they botched hatched on overdrive. I even called Psycho Kid by this guy's name. Hey, I mean, that was a botch, but I'm glad I caught it. And Psycho Edge, thankfully I got it right. Not Psycho Kid, that's a guy in overdrive. Hey, wait a minute though, I was gonna say he had the advantage, but not so. Oh, wait a minute though, he just kicked Farrell off of him. Oh, wait a minute, he's just gonna swing him around and around on the tire swing again. Just spun him around like nobody's business. As Hawkins 07 would say, he had just thrown him like yesterday's garbage. But here. Oh, wait a minute. Elbow drop by Psycho Edge. And he's got a cover on here. There's two. No, two count. But yeah. Of course, fighting for a spot in the Fatal 4-Way. Hey, whoever wins the Fatal 4-Way at Thursday Night Mayhem will move on to Summer Bash and take on Vincent, and who's qualified by default, and MTY, and the BYU Championship's going to be online. And Psycho Edge is again taking this thing outside. Right. Ow! Right into that barricade! And look at him just hammer away on him like he's beating on the drum set. Douche, 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 douche. But anyway. And while I'm at it. Since this match was recorded later, I can say this. This mad props go to the XWA. I still have yet to watch the whole Blood Bowl, but I'm enjoying what I've seen so far. You guys are doing a hell of a job. And definitely, I got a message. Happy anniversary to SCAW. They just did their anniversary show. I thought it was fantastic. I thought it was one of the best call shows I've seen. And I mean, Lone Star, you really pulled out the stops. And it worked, dude. Dude, congratulations. And wait a minute, Farrell tried to catch him with a wall, but he landed too close to the ropes. But yeah, it was like Hawkins 07 was saying, and I apologize for not concentrating on this match too much. I just have a lot to say tonight. Of course, Hawkins is interested in, well, what he's saying is he's basically sending a shout out if you're interested in helping us out with commentary now and then, but like he said and I said, I'm content with doing two brands, and I'm happy on Aftershock, and even yes on Overdrive. Even though the AK is an annoying piece of trash, I'd be having as much fun if I weren't on Overdrive. I love being on Overdrive. I love being on Aftershock. And... Whoa! Oh, no! Right through the second timekeeper's table! Well, sweet Annie M! But yeah, if anyone wants to do EBA, that's fine, because as I'm the voice of BYU. I'm the voice of BYU. I think I'm fine doing just Aftershock and Overdrive. And like we both said, it would be too much for me to do all three of those brands. I got enough to worry about. Oh, rake in the back by Farrell. Of course, like I said, these two faced off against each other a few weeks ago. Oh, botch! Excuse me, guys. It's been a rough day. And Farrell, kicking away at the leg like he's doing the Russian dance. But yeah, just for the record, wait a minute, Farrell's got a figure four leg lock. He's got the figure four leg lock on Psycho Edge. And Psycho Edge with balls of steel. He didn't tap out. And he just sends Farrell outside. But yeah, of course, our next event is going to be Thursday Night Mayhem. And Steve Farrell's getting introduced to the steel stairs on the outside. You know, it's funny, on EBA, Hawkins of 7 was wondering why I always call Psycho Edge the table rapist. Because, it's pretty obvious. The man is obsessed with tables. Well, it's like I've said before, he probably sleeps with one. Or maybe on one. He's probably too cheap to afford to afford even a small-sized mattress. Probably for his two-bedroom job of apartment somewhere in parts unknown. At one point, IJD Cage used to live in parts unknown, but I've been thinking of moving to the Green Hill Zone. Actually, I keep a summer place out there, but that's another story for another day. And Psycho Edge, ready to close this story! There's the execution from the top rope! And man, he's got a cover here. This one's going to be over. Yes, it is over. Psycho Edge is going to be one of the four men moving on to that fatal four-way for Thursday Night Mayhem. Only question is, will he repeat that success and move on to face Vincent and MT Wild at Summer Bash? I'm pretty sure we'll find out when we get to Thursday Night Mayhem. We'll be right back. Let's get on with it. Slayer's on his way out here next. Man. You know, running out of things to talk about here, you know? I talked about EBA for you guys, if I had seen it, but at the time I did this episode, I had yet to see it. Slayer is getting ready for some competition here. And boy, is he gonna have some competition. Slayer, normally a tag wrestler, is quickly moving up the ranks, but he might just hit a roadblock. Our name Danny Legend, because that's going to be his opponent here. And we see Danny Legend making his way out here. He's quickly become a household name in BYU. And he makes it no secret in shoving that name down everybody's throat. He's got a good record. He made it all the way to the finals in the Royal Showdown. Right now, he's got a chance to qualify for that fatal four-way match for Thursday Night Mayhem.